A cognitive walkthrough is a task-based usability inspection technique used to evaluate the learnability of a system from the perspective of a new user. Now, unlike user testing, there are no actual users involved, which is what makes it a nice, low-cost option to evaluate an interface. Cognitive walkthroughs are specifically meant to evaluate system learnability. So experts assess the design of the system for common activities from the perspective of a new user learning a new system. That being the case, they're most effective to assess systems with complex, new, or unfamiliar workflows or functionalities. For example, imagine a tablet application used by patients of a health clinic so that when they arrive for their appointment, they can check in and update any personal information that's on file. Most users probably wouldn't have much, if any, prior experience with the type of tool like this. And because it has a very niche use case, the interface itself is likely to employ new or unfamiliar design patterns. These factors are what make it a good candidate for a cognitive walkthrough assessment. On the flip side, doing a cognitive walkthrough to assess something like an e-commerce checkout flow probably wouldn't be necessary, since most people are pretty familiar with these types of experiences. Cognitive walkthroughs take place in a workshop setting where a cross-functional team of reviewers come together and literally walk through each step of a user flow. And collectively, they answer a set of prescribed questions for analysis. The goal is to identify aspects of the interface that might be challenging for new users. Walkthrough reviewers might include people of various UX specialty, product owners, engineers, or subject matter experts. A facilitator leads the group of evaluators through the task flow. While the evaluators offer their interpretation of how a particular type of user might perceive the interface and thus how they might behave in a given situation. It's a great idea to leverage your user personas as the basis for these walkthroughs because they'll help you to get everyone on the same page around the context and mindsets of the users for which they're evaluating. Now, during the actual evaluation of a given task, the facilitator moves through the interface and stops at each new screen, or if not a new screen, each new discrete step in the interaction flow. Then, to establish whether the user is likely to succeed or fail at each step, the evaluators discuss four key questions designed to uncover potential fail points. The first question for analysis is, will the user try to achieve the right result? In other words, would the user understand that the action or necessary next step is necessary to reach their larger goal? Prompt number two asks, will the user notice that the correct action is available? In other words, is the interactive element that achieves the action visible or easily findable on the interface? Number three asks, will the user associate the correct action with the result they're trying to achieve? So, the correct button might be visible on the page, but will users understand the label and will they know to engage with it? And lastly, reviewers are asked to determine whether users see that progress has been made toward their goal after the action is complete. In other words, based on what occurs after the action is taken, the reviewers will assess whether the users will know that the action was correct and that it actually helped them make progress toward their goal. The analysis framework for cognitive walkthroughs is based on what is known in cognitive psychology about how humans assess and interact with new interfaces. It's a proven way to evaluate the learnability of a system and identify improvements when access to real end users or resources for usability testing might not be available. However, walkthroughs are just one way to evaluate design, and ideally they should be combined with other assessment methods to gain a more comprehensive understanding of the effectiveness of your product's design.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.